Hey Turtle, do you know what your email subscribers are doing on your site? A lot of us are wondering. It is important for nonprofits to understand what your email subscribers are doing on your site because these are your loyal supporters. Using data from your email marketing tool and Google Analytics, you can very clearly track what a user does when they click onto your website from that email campaign. But what if you want to look at a full journey of what the subscriber does when they go to your site through other sources like direct or referral or social? What we're going to do today is examine data in the email service provider, and we'll look at data in Google Analytics, and then finally, a way that will intelligently help you tie the data together to understand a full subscriber's journey on your site. Let's jump first into an example of what you can see in your email marketing tool. Within the MailChimp campaign report, you can see for each email that you sent out, the most clicked on links to understand what type of content resonated best with your subscribers. And then you can even get more granular by looking at who among your subscribers clicked on each of those individual links. If you want to get a better understanding of how email subscribers are behaving on your site after they click on that email link, you can go into Google Analytics to drill in on the campaign that you sent out. You can look at the same data for a specific campaign that you were looking at in MailChimp or your email service provider by creating a segment with a unique email campaign identifier. Once you create that segment, you can compare session quality metrics to other segments on your site. For example, in this report, once you've applied the email segment, you can then see that the email segment is outperforming regular traffic on your site with higher page per session, higher average session duration, and then lower bounce rate. Another interesting thing you can see here is that the email segment has a much higher portion of returning visitors. There's still this bridge that we need to build. Turtle, your email subscriber, may return the next time your site not from email, but from referral or direct. And those sessions should still be attributed to Turtle so that you can understand her full engagement journey with your website. We hear this need from nonprofits all the time, and this is exactly why we built Lighthouse. It is built on top of the Google Analytics API, and it also has a tight integration with MailChimp. So this is what happens when you have Lighthouse fully integrated on your site. When Turtle, your subscriber, opens an email newsletter that you sent to your entire list, and she clicks on a link in that newsletter that leads to your site, her email is then captured in Lighthouse along with her unique Google Analytics ID that will be able to tell you for up to the past 2 years every activity she had on your website, regardless of the source of that session. But wait a minute. An email subscriber can open your organization's newsletter on multiple devices, so how can we tell if all of those opens belong to the same person? Well, Lighthouse can help you with that, because with this unique tracking, if Turtle opened your newsletter on her iPhone and then her iPad and her computer, we're able to bind all of those three different IDs together and attribute them to Turtle, so you get a full understanding of how your subscriber is interacting with your website on multiple devices. All right, Turtle, I hope that gave you a few tips into understanding what your email subscribers are doing on your website. You should look at your email marketing data, you can look at Google Analytics, but also give Lighthouse a try. You can find Lighthouse at getlighthouse.io. Have fun.